A wise man buys when everyone else is selling, and he holds it until everyone else is buying. It's not a catchy slogan, but it's the very essence of successful investment. With this, I'm Tisha from Holy Child Public School, and me along with Bhumika and Purva are here to tell you some interesting information on money today. Let's begin. Money is often considered as a medium of exchange, or we can say that it is an item which is accepted as a payment for the exchange of goods and services. There are four forms of money too, which are fiat money, fiduciary money, full-bodied money and credit money. Now we will be discussing about the forms of money. The very first form of money is fiat money. It is that form of money which is accepted as a medium of exchange by the people of country because of the government decree. The people are legally bound to accept it as a medium of exchange. It includes all the coins as well as notes. Coming over the next form of money, which is fiduciary money. It is that form of money where the people accept it as a medium of exchange because of the trust between the payer and the payee. It is not accepted as a medium of exchange by the people because of any government decree. We can say that checks is an example of fiduciary form.
The first two forms of money are explained to you by Tisha. So now it's my turn to explain you all the other two forms of money. So let's begin. The third form of money is full-bodied money. In this form of money, both the money value and the commodity value are the same. Let us understand this with the help of an example. Just think about a 5 rupee coin. A 5 rupee coin has its money value of rupee 5, as you can buy anything worth rupee 5 from that coin. Also, coming to its commodity value, it is also 5, as the expenditure incurred in preparing that coin of 5 is the same. So, by this we can say that the money value and the commodity value of a 5 rupee coin are equal, which means it is a full-bodied money. The fourth form of money is credit money. Credit money is a form of money in which the money value is more than the commodity value. Let us understand this with the help of an example. Let's talk about a 2000 rupee note. A 2000 rupee note has its money value of 2000, as we can buy anything worth rupees 2000 from that 2000 rupee note. But what about its commodity value? Its commodity value is much more lesser than rupees 2000, as the commodity value of a note includes the expenses incurred to prepare that note. So to prepare a note of 2000, only rupees 20 to 30 are involved, which are very much lesser than rupees 2000. So here the money value is more than the commodity value. This is called credit money. So at the end, I just want to say that money is what money does, as there is no commercial activity which is possible without the existence of money. So I hope you found our video interesting. We'll be back with some more. Thank you for watching our video. Thank you.